Greetings. Bless your heart, Brother Alex. You wrote, "If you can show me the mistake in the Quran, I'll leave it right now." Mistakes? Let's first look at a historical mistake. The Quran wrongly lists the plagues that God brought against Egypt. Historical facts list 10 plagues. Number 1, water to blood, frogs, gnats or lice, flies, deceased livestock, boils, thunder and hail, locusts, darkness for 3 days, death of the firstborn. Now what does the Quran list? In Surah 7:133, the Quran lists only 5. This is the Wahiduddin. "Then we afflicted them with storms and locusts and lice and frogs and blood." So many clear signs. "But they were steeped in arrogance, for they were a people given to sin." The author of the Quran could only list 5. Storms, which I'm counting as floods, grasshoppers, lice, frogs, and blood. The typical response Islam has invented, brother, and see if you've heard this, is that Allah did not intend the actual list to be full and correct. I understand the need for such human rationalization, brother. The Quran is incomplete, and therefore incorrect. But if it is incorrect and from Allah, then Allah cannot be the God who made heaven and earth. So anyone committed to defending the Quran must reason it cannot be incorrect, therefore completeness cannot matter. But less than 10, or the wrong 10, is an error, brother, a mistake, a failure. Let's also look at a second historical mistake, so you know there is more than just one. You need to consider the weight of the evidence. The Quran does not even include all 10 commandments. Consider for the moment, there is no actual list anywhere in the Quran. If you think I am wrong, produce your proof, brother. Produce surah and ayat where Muhammad confirmed the 10 commandments by listing them. If you look and dig and get creative and invent, you can find 9 concepts that are similar to 9 of the 10 commandments. But nowhere in the Quran does the author bother to command, "Remember the Sabbath to keep it holy." So that is 2 historical mistakes, brother. You wrote, "If you can show me the mistake in the Quran, I'll leave it right now." I am not going to rant and call names if you break your promise. I fully appreciate the weight of the issue you face, brother. I think you should also consider doctrinal errors in the Quran. The Quran calls Jews polytheists. And that is so absolutely false, I cannot imagine why no Muslim can recognize the error. Surah 9:28. This is the Sahih. "O you who have believed, indeed the polytheists are unclean." So we're talking about the polytheists here. "Fight those who do not believe in Allah or in the last day, or who do not consider unlawful what Allah and His Messenger have made unlawful." So anyone who does not believe in what Allah and His Messenger have made unlawful, they are polytheists. Surah 9:30, continuing on. The Jews say Ezra is the son of Allah, and the Christians say the Messiah is the son of Allah. That is their statement from their mouths. Now researching this, I find a fascinating problem with Islam, brother. I call it overgeneralization, brother. The Jews say. This statement is made with no basis. And if you look into the Islamic defense of this claim, it will look like the following. The Islamic exegetes have mentioned that there existed a community of Jews in Yemen who considered Ezra as son of God. Which means all Jews are accused, while the factoid, "The Jews say," may only apply to a few, a small, isolated group. That is a mistake of approach as well as doctrine, brother. The mistake is that Judaism is not polytheistic, brother. if there even was a small fringe group who thought Ezra was Messiah. And I want to take a brief diversion, brother, so that you realize the implication. The Quran goes to the trouble to prove that Messiah means the Son of God. The Jewish people have longed for the Messiah to come, and rightly so. But the Quran mixes Messiah as the Son of God. In all probability, because Jesus was the Messiah, and Christians call him Son of God. The author of the Quran could not tell the difference. They have taken their scholars and monks as lords besides Allah, and also the Messiah, the Son of Mary. They, the polytheist Jews, according to the Quran. This is simply a gross error in the Quran, brother. So the Quran commits gross error calling the Jews polytheists, and by extension, Judaism as polytheism. And another error that the Quran contains, brother, is an argument that Mary is prayed to as a god by Christians. Mary is not part of the Trinity, but Muhammad created his argument against this misunderstanding or ignorance of Christianity. Surah 573. They do blaspheme who say Allah is one of three in a Trinity, for there is no God except one, Allah. Christ, the Son of Mary, was no more than an apostle. Many were the apostles that passed away before him. His mother was a woman of truth. They had both to eat their daily food. See how God makes his clear signs to them. Yet see in what ways they are deluded away from the truth. There is no reason, brother, to mention Mary ate food. There is no reason, brother, to include Mary at all, except to prove Mary is not God. Because in Islam, Allah does not need food is an important fact about Allah. Therefore, by stating Mary ate food, it argues Mary is not Allah or partner with Allah. But one only needs to make this argument, brother, if arguing against the claim that Mary is God. But there is nobody on earth making that claim, brother. So Muhammad's argument, brother, against Mary being a god means Muhammad, or the author of the Quran, wrongly thought that the Christian Trinity was God the Father, Jesus God the Son, and Mary God the Mother. That is four mistakes, brother. I understand you have much to consider, but the mistakes are clear. Realize I am not the first to point out these mistakes, brother. And after 1400 years, Islam will have excuses for these mistakes. And you have to decide if you accept their weak excuses or not. But one last contradiction is not discussed much. Surah 5:17 declares Allah has a covenant with Christians. However, there is one and only one covenant between Christians and God, brother. Only one that any Christians on earth, now or at any time in the past, only one covenant which our God has made with us. It was made by Jesus and his death on the cross. And by asserting the covenant exists, brother, the Quran asserts the event that establishes the covenant. And that means Surah 5:17 asserts Jesus died on the cross, brother. And that directly contradicts Surah 4, 157. You wrote, "If you can show me the mistake in the Quran, I'll leave it right now." I have shown you five irrefutable mistakes, brother. I am not going to rant and call names if you break your promise, brother. Only you can decide in your heart if you sincerely want the truth of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.